VP of Government Affairs for Susan B. Anthony List, a pro-life organization out of Washington, D.C. And there is a reason that we are in Columbus, Ohio today. We are here to show our support for Rick Santorum, a true pro-life hero. I served in the House when Rick Santorum was in the Senate. I'm a former congresswoman from the great state of Colorado. And we knew when we worked in the House on the life issue that we could always count on Rick Santorum to come through in the Senate for us. Whether or not it was working to end the gruesome practice of partial birth abortion, standing up for moms and dads around this country on parental notification, we knew that Rick always had the courage to do what was right for those precious unborn children. We knew that he would work very hard to work on conscience protection so that pharmacists and other medical providers don't have to choose between violating their conscience and having a dog. That's why we're happy to endorse Rick Santorum. Rick Santorum is the first signer of our presidential pro-life pledge. Rick Santorum committed to working to defund Planned Parenthood. He said that he would nominate judges that would legislate from the bench. Don't we all want judges that will act like judges instead of legislators? He also said that for the cabinet positions that were so relevant to our cause, that he would nominate, that he would select pro-life and would also work to advance POP legislation, acknowledging that unborn child. So Rick Santorum has been a hero for us, and how wonderful it is to be in a state that can make all the difference in this presidential primary. I'm honored today to stand here with Mike DeWine, the Attorney General. When you talk to people here, it's said that Mike DeWine is always there when he's needed the most. So I would like to ask Mike DeWine.